This video is going to show how some new features can be used to investigate graphical performance improvements in Cuis. Since much of the current drawing infrastructure was inherited from Squeak, most of what this video covers should apply there as well. The fact that we are still operating with the VM designed for a graphics architecture from the 1970s suggests an area to investigate. There is generally no draw caching or buffering in the image, just direct to the VM screen buffer redraws. So let's look at redraw due to screen damage, since that appears to be some low-hanging fruit. This is running the 3245 image, and you can see we've got the familiar bouncing atoms morph, a few browsers, and a workspace. Note the frame rate in the upper left corner of the bouncing atoms window. It's pretty stable right now at around 110 to 120 FPS. Now let's drag one of the browser windows on top of it. You can see that just dragging the window slows things down. This is because every time you move a morph, it needs to be redrawn. Notice that the frame rate has decreased significantly. That's because every time the bouncing atoms morph draws, visible morphs above and below it need to be redrawn as well. The method being displayed was chosen for this demo because it's relatively expensive to redraw. Now let's look at something that's easier to draw. Notice the frame rate has gone up. Let's drag a second browser on top of the first. Again, the frame rate goes down. Switching to the shorter method again speeds things up. Now we'll drag a third morph on top of the first two. And again, the frame rate drops. If we bring the second browser on top of the third, there's no longer a portion of the third morph that needs to redraw, and frame rates go up. I'm showing this for two reasons. The first is that the drawing system is reasonably intelligent as to what needs to be drawn, so that's not the issue. The second reason is to show that morphic drawing performance can be wildly variable based on a large number of factors that aren't always obvious. To try to get to the bottom of what's going on here, let's take a look at the existing tools we have available. The first is the process browser. This shows us that the image is spending all of its time drawing. Gee, thanks. The second is the profiler. This provides a good low-level view of what's being called, but really doesn't give us the big picture. It's great for when you have a single chunk of code to optimize. Not so good when you have a lot of interacting chunks of code like we're dealing with here. The third tool we have is looking at screen damage. This is useful for seeing where on the screen things are being drawn, but not much else. It succeeds at not being high level enough while simultaneously not providing detail. But in fairness, it really wasn't designed for this type of work. There's also a second variant of damage visualization. This provides a better view of what things are being drawn, but is still not what is needed. Plus, it is so much more resource intensive that the image is quite unresponsive. I can't even turn it off using the mouse. So far, I've shown that there's a lot of drawing going on, and that I don't think the existing tools are up to the task. But of course, that's what this video is about. Time to stop complaining and show you a solution. Now I'm going to switch to an image with my recent pull request applied. This is change set 3246 in the Morphic drawing proxy package. This will allow us to try out different ideas and build what we need as we go. The layout is bouncing atoms surrounding two browser windows with an explorer window next to its respective browser. First, let's just use the profiler proxy. All this does is gather drawing statistics that we'll need to understand what's going on. Here, I'm just showing that injecting them has negligible impact on the frame rate. So far, so good. Now let's inject the profiler on the left and a profiling cache on the right. I'm pretty sure that a cache is at least part of the solution to this issue, but you can't be sure unless you measure, right? Notice that right away, we can see the frame rate has gone up. Let's see what the profilers can tell us. This first group of seven proxies represent the morphs in the right-hand browser we've injected into. The four panes at the top, a text field with some method information, the text field below, and one hidden morph that isn't being drawn right now. The second group of seven proxies represent the same morphs in the left-hand browser we've injected into. Now let's refresh the statistics a couple of times. This is getting old. Let's turn on monitoring. That's better. We can also drill in and see more detailed statistics. We've got both counts and timings. For hits, where we just draw from the cache. Canvas misses, where the cache needs to be created. Dirty misses, where the cache exists but no longer represents the morph's contents and needs to be redrawn. This is much better. We now have details that tell us that caching appears to be helping significantly and how it's performing at a morph level versus just redrawing the entire morph each frame. And we've done all this without touching the morph's own drawing code. It effectively doesn't know or care that we're here from a drawing standpoint. That's two kinds of changes in two kinds of morphs, which would require you to invasively create four morph subclasses without the proxies. This is great, but one problem is that this presentation leaves a lot to be desired in terms of readability. Time for a new experiment. Let's create a subclass of the profiling cache proxy. And we'll have it draw its own state on top of the morph. Inject the new proxy. Oops, that's a bug. Let's fix that. Now scroll those panes up so we can see the results. It would really be great if we could get a similar view in the left browser. Create another subclass. Add the drawing code. And inject the proxy. Same bug, different place. Let's fix that. And scroll the panes up. Notice the brief flash of yellow when the morph actually changes. I think this is pretty great. We've added profiling, a drawing overlay with and without caching, which results in an easy-to-understand and compare presentation, all while keeping the UI responsive and interactive. And we still haven't touched the morph's own code. Now the results may have you convinced that adding caching to some kinds of morphs is the way to go. Or maybe it makes sense to do some more research into if these morphs could be made to draw more efficiently first. A follow-up experiment might be to create and inject a profiling canvas. This would let you see what kinds of drawing these morphs are doing and how much time is being spent in each of the various draw calls. Or perhaps you've noticed that the average times were ticking up, and much more quickly in the left-hand browser than on the right. That seems worth investigating. There are two main points that I hope I successfully made in this video. The first is that significant performance gains appear to be attainable without major surgery to existing code. Also, that with better tools, understanding performance issues and experimenting with solutions doesn't have to be the tedious chore that it is currently. Thanks for watching.